So this is our documentation of the illegal show we played?
Yeah.
Dan and Paul reminisce about Brickworks.
Do you know which laws we broke?
Yes.
Breaking and entering.
Trespassing.
Trespassing. Consumption of alcohol in a public place. Noise violations.
Definitely broke the bylaw there. Well, those cops did show up. I think they realized they were a little out of their league.
Yeah.
The two cops that showed up weren't going to remove the thousands of people.
It was pouring with rain. We had no idea where we were. There was a fence way over there, and they had cut a big hole, a human-sized hole through it. And we had to go one by one through the hole in the rain.
In pitch blackness as well.
Yeah, yeah, no lights.
Hey guys, we gotta go this way.
All right.
Sorry, that's the way we went in last time.
Think of ourselves as making electro-pop. And I think what people like about our band is the energy that we bring in our live show. Given that there's only two of us, it makes for a really intense live situation because we don't use computers, so there's a lot of tactile playing happening. Do you want to talk about the Brickworks show?
Well, the thing that I'll never forget is it was like a gigantic building, like hundreds of thousands of square feet. You could get lost in there, and it was pitch black, and people were walking around with these flashlights that barely lit up enough to see just in front of you, and you're just walking through this blackness.
It was pouring with rain. It was Halloween.
And the building was leaking. At one point, I walked for what felt like 10 minutes, and I'm walking down this corridor, and I looked down another corridor, really far down. There's this group of people spit roasting a pig and just grabbing flesh off the pig and eating it. And they're like shirtless and just like, it was this crazy, carnal, like savage ritual that was going on down the hall.
The opening band was called Missile Command, and they just screamed and cut themselves with glass and shot Roman candles into the crowd. And I remember them hitting this guy who was wearing a kilt.
And he lit on fire.
And he lit on fire, and he came up and he decked the lead singer.
He got really mad, and the funniest thing was the reaction of the people who were really into Missile Command was that, like, what a buzzkill. I can't believe this guy's taking it so personally.
To be on a bill with the bands that we were on the bill with that night was huge for us.
Yeah, just what those people were doing by putting that show on, it was so ambitious.
Yeah.
You know, it was like a scale that I've never seen before of this like underground activity. It was really crazy.
Now, I remember like we didn't really know the organizers or anything.
Yeah, we didn't know anybody except the band that was playing after us.
And they weren't around.
And they weren't there, yeah. We played right here.
Yeah, we did.
It was right, this is where the stage was. And then the DJs were down this thing. So there was like a dance party down this.
And the pig was like way the hell over
way
there.
Way down there, down another thing. Like, and like, down another
and
corridor. You had
to, and it was all dark. It was all dark.
This is where Dan made out with the girl.
Right here, right here. We didn't see this sign last time.
I'm pretty sure that means there was definite asbestos exposure. Yeah, like, there was definitely a lot of this.
And a lot of like, I mean, nice bricks though, right?
Yeah, they made some quality bricks.
This is like your classic Toronto brick. People would be like, oh, like they played at the Brickworks. It was a crazy night. They're gonna play at, you know, Sneaky D's. It's gonna be a crazy night, right? You kind of always take that with you, that performance that you did, that place that you played.